His Excellency General Michel Sleiman, President of the Lebanese Republic, His Excellency Mr. Najim Miqati, President of the Council of Ministers, both represented by Excellency Mr. Walid Daoud, Your Excellencies, President Peter Dorman, Dean George Najjar, ladies and gentlemen. I'm standing here in front of you today to honor my son, my beloved son. May his soul rest in peace. It has never crossed my mind that I will ever be in such a position. I've always looked to the future with Rami taking the lead, not only in business, but for the family too, trusting that with his vision and judgment, he will carry on the flame so when I depart, I would have peace of mind. But fate was stronger than dreams and hopes. God bestowed death on Rami for reasons that are beyond reasoning. Today, I humbly and spiritually sense his presence with us, a presence that is full of pride and gratitude for our joint project that expresses what was dearest to his heart. I only wish that Rami could have been here to be addressing you from this podium. I think you would have enjoyed this very much with him bringing to this great and unique wit, charm and wisdom, as he had done in so many other seminars, lectures, and workshops. I know some of you in this room had the pleasure of hearing Rami addressing an audience, so you will know exactly what I mean. Ever since Rami took over the management of our family business when he was only 25, he had a vision of his own. He wanted to build for tomorrow and not for today, and was very much concerned that the business principles and values he had learned at business schools were being implemented by our management team worldwide. I found my calling in this organization, he said one day. His approach to leadership is fundamentally centered on what he used to call the core principles of listening, selfishness for selflessness, and clarity of goals. He voiced his concerns at the outset, but later on became so obsessed with the idea of proper governance, selection and deselection, succession, planning, independent directors, board committees, audits, controls, and most importantly, comprehensive transparency. These were the dream, the terms and the dreams that he kept repeating until he managed through evolution and revolution initiatives that he had implemented throughout our group of companies to instill the foundation of well-designed corporate governance as he led the business through a period of exponential growth. Rami was also committed to corporate social responsibility and believed that big businesses could be a beneficial, non-detrimental force in the world. Thanks to Rami, Future Pipe Industries now has a robust culture of corporate governance, led by a board comprised of both executive and independent non-executive members who oversee and guide all aspects of our group's business. We also have ethics and social responsibility policies, which are embedded in our corporate culture. I'm convinced we benefit greatly from these initiatives. Rami has written and lectured about these concepts. He rallied senior executives and board directors around his ideas and was so excited about these issues to the point that had the day-to-day business not kept him from doing it, he would have dedicated his life to teaching people how to do things better. He was perfectly conscious of the impact on a business of volatility in unstable economies and has always promoted the value of strengthening one's ability to adapt from within to changes in the external world. For him, change is the constant force that is driving our industry into the future. We see now how right he was. He wanted to do all this following the highest standards of ethics. Moral integrity and honesty would always be for Rami the driving values. Adopting moral values throughout his short life and being by nature a very humble person did not prevent Rami from being firm when it came to business. Do it now and get it done is what he used to say. Be humble, be accountable. He also wanted to pass the message that one can be firm and humble at the same time, but still be accountable and only then share the wealth, success, and knowledge. As an active member of the board of directors of the Young Arab Leaders, and also a member of the Young Presidents Organization, he shared with his contemporaries his great belief in the development of youth and the enhancement of the entrepreneurship skills. This was not only an end in itself. He felt this was the best way to change the misguided negative image of young Arab men and women propagated by the Western media. This is why he accompanied me through all my visits to the world leaders. At the time, some people were hesitant and uncomfortable about my decision to promote Rami at such a young age to a senior role within our family business, doubting whether he had sufficient experience to succeed in the role. Of course, as a new graduate, he could not have managed without having experienced things firsthand. He had to start from the factory floor and go up through all departments to understand the processes needed to complete our work. Before graduating, he always accompanied me to meetings and witnessed the negotiations of contracts and the purchase of companies, which gave him a first-hand experience that is not found in textbooks. Even when he did his master's degree, he had it catered to the needs of the company, so he was better placed to take the leading role. My decision to appoint Rami as my successor was taken after a lot of thought and after watching him grow and perform in an increasingly mature and assured manner. Rami flourished with the responsibility, bringing passion, vision, ambition, and great humanity to his administration of business. Rami was conscious that it is a leader's responsibility to set an example, so he lived his principles every minute of every day. I had faith in him, and he did not disappoint me at all. I would encourage anyone faced with a similar choice to do likewise and embrace all that the next generation can bring to a business and guide them through their first steps and then leave them to soar. Our family friend, Dr. Nasser Saidi, who is an esteemed independent member of the Future Pipe Industries Group Board and in which capacity used to work regularly with Rami, has been the driving force behind the idea of setting up a chair in corporate governance. I was immediately taken by the idea as I felt that it captured many of Rami's beliefs. I trust that this chair will serve to promote and develop these beliefs, particularly the importance of robust corporate governance in the Middle East and also the evolution of family business in the modern era. But why such a chair at AUB? Very simple. This is exactly where my wife, May Na'mani, and I started our university education. May went to pharmacy school, from where she graduated in 1975, and I left for the U.S. to pursue a degree in chemical engineering, which unfortunately AUB did not offer at that time. Rami had also recently very happily settled and made his home in Beirut. So AUB Ulayan School of Business is certainly the most appropriate house to welcome the chair. Generations of beneficiaries of the chair's offerings will honor the vision that Rami had of a clean business environment through best ethical practices, being the repository of Rami's written materials, a wealth of the ideas and dreams that Rami was unfortunately not given the time to see come true, will be harnessed to pave their way to realization. The chair will also supervise the publishing of a book which commemorates Rami's vision and outlook of a better future for all. This chair and its offerings allow Rami to continue to lead us by example for decades to come. In doing so, it will give pride to his girls, May, Yasmina, and Noor, knowing that their father's vision is still carried on for future generations, inspiring them to follow in his footsteps and hopefully leave a mark in this world. For us, his parents and sisters, Tamara and Camelia, it would also be a step in our healing process, knowing that his untimely departure did not go in vain. Before stepping down, I would like to extend my family's most sincere thanks to the AUB President, Dr. Peter Dorman, to the Dean, Dr. Najjar, his associate, Dr. Asim Safiyuddin, the Assistant Vice President, Dr. Imad Balbaki, and of course, last but not no means least, Mrs. Salma Awaida, for having spared the time and efforts to set up and launch the chair for Rami Fouad Makhzoumi. Thank you all, and may God rest Rami's soul in peace.